Hello everyone, welcome to Gate Academy.
Let us ask some in general question. As you told me that you are from Rajasthan and you love Thar Desert.
That you press the button on mobile and then the corresponding tube light or fan will turn on or turned off. So now I am thinking of currently that you don't use mobile, you don't use any contact, you just show some gesture to it. Like if you show this hand to the switchboard, then the tube light will be on. And if you show this, then it will be off. Something like that.
अगर मैं हेडलॉक को वहाँ पे मिनिमाइज करूँगा, तो मतलब मेरा वहाँ पे जो हीट जनरेशन हो रहा है, वो किस वजह से हो रहा है? सुपर कम का ड्रॉप. Hello everyone, welcome to Gate Academy. अभी आपका एक इंटरव्यू का सीरीज चल रहा है जिससे हम हमारे जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं हम जिन्होंने गेट में बहुत अच्छा स्कोर किया है, जिनके रैंक्स आए हैं और जिनके इंटरव्यू आगे पीएससी प्लस आईआईटीज एंड कुछ रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट में पॉसिबल है, तो उनके लिए मॉक इंटरव्यू हम कंडक्ट कर रहे हैं. तो उसी सीरीज में हमारे साथ जुड़ चुके हैं आयान किशोरे और साथ के साथ मेरे साथ मेरे सहयोगी वेणुगोपाल शर्मा सर. हेलो सर, कैसे हैं?
बढ़िया सर, आप कैसे हैं?
मैं बढ़िया सर. आयान, आप कैसे हो?
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग सर, मैं अच्छा हूँ, थैंक यू.
गुड मॉर्निंग. सो डियर, नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट इंटरव्यू. ओके, सो आयान, टेल मी अबाउट योरसेल्फ.
सर, विद ऑल ड्यू रिस्पेक्ट, आई अज्यूम दैट यू हैव माय रिज्यूमे एंड यू हैव गॉन थ्रू इट, सो आई विल बी टेलिंग यू समथिंग दैट इज नॉट इन देयर. Sir, I am a good team player and I am not lazy type of person. If you give me some tasks, then I will be doing that way before deadline. I will trying to do that at worst on the deadline. And also, I'm that kind of person who loves to motivate others, who loves to bring a positive aura with him when he enters the room. That is the type of personality I believe I have. And I was a leader in my college of the NCC group. So that experience come handy to me when it comes to prioritizing things, or when it comes to connect with the superiors, or connect with the juniors, or connect with the peers. So I easily blend myself in that environment. That's all about myself.
Okay, Ayan. So just tell me something that about the things which you have interest in, like your hobbies.
Sir, primarily I have an interest in playing guitar and playing piano. I have interest in the musical things. Like I love to play with the notes. I love to make music on myself. I love to create the tabs and everything. And coming to the sports side, I love to play table tennis because I believe that it improves my reflexes and my reaction times. And apart from the curriculum, other hobby is that I love to build new things and explore new things in the Arduino. Arduino is a different area of the robotics section. It basically deals with the mechatronics style. So I love to explore new things and build new projects on the Arduino. And I have mentioned some of our projects in the resume.
Okay. So as you have told me that you have interest in playing guitar and musical instruments. So is there any favorite guitarist you have? Who is your favorite guitarist?
Sir, Luca Stricagnoli.
Okay.
Loves to play fingerstyle.
Okay, so fingerstyle guitar. Okay. Yes, now, coming to the technical part, okay, what are your achievement and specialization areas in various technical subjects?
So, in technical subjects related to my program in engineering, that is mechanical engineering, I have interests in fluid mechanics, heat transfer, and in machine design, and also somewhat interest in theory of machines. And apart from my area of mechanical engineering, I also have some interest in the electronics, some basic interest in the electronics and this Arduino thing.
Okay, just because you are interested in robotics part, so you would be aware of different electronic things which you deal with.
The basic is on the scratch level, I'm aware of things.
Okay, so if I ask you that there is a beam, okay, there is a beam, simply supported beam, okay, and there is a point load at the midspan. Okay, so tell me about the shear force distribution across the length of the beam.
Sir, I'd like to take a minute or two if you would allow me.
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you.
You can also paint it. You can use also print paper. No?
Thank you.
Done. Or you need more time?
So just 30 seconds more, please.
Okay. Take it.
Yes, I've done.
Show me if you have drawn anything.
This diagram.
CFO's diagram. Okay, good. So I am going to ask a few questions from this. Okay, so be prepared. First question, if you just decentralize the point load, okay, it is acting exactly at the midspan of the beam. So if you just make it acting at somewhere else, like you will be applying an eccentric load over the beam. Okay, then what will happen? You will see that one part of the shear force diagram will be taller as compared to the remaining part, right? Right now it is equal but in opposite sides, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I'm asking you a question. So if there is a load that is a centric load, okay, then one part of the beam will be having larger shear forces and one part will be having smaller shear forces. Now if I ask you to calculate the maximum shear stress, transverse shear stress, okay, so first you need to tell me what is the formula for that. And second thing, what will be the value of shear force? What value of shear force you will take? Okay. Then just start your answer.
Sir, I am assuming the beam is of rectangular cross section.
Yeah. Any cross section, any standard cross section you can go.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I'm done.
Done. Okay. Show me.
Sir, this will be the shear force diagram. If
okay.
Load is at a distance A from one end and B from the other end. So total length will be A plus B. So this will be the shear force diagram. The maximum shear force will be PB upon L on the acting on the smaller side of the beam, and the minimum will be P upon L. And the maximum shear, the formula for the shear stress in the beam is given by tau is equal to VA Y bar upon VI, where tau is the shear stress, V is the shear force acting on the cross section, A Y bar is the first moment of area about the neutral axis, then B is the width of the beam, and I is the moment of area about the whole cross section. Then the maximum shear stress for the rectangular beam, because we have assumed the rectangular beam, is a 3 by 2 times of the average shear stress. And the average shear stress will be the shear force per unit area of the cross section of the beam. So by that formula, I have calculated the maximum shear stress as 3P upon 2LH. H is the height of the beam.
Okay. L is the height of the beam.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What the value you have taken as the maximum shear force is?
So PB upon
L. PB upon L. Very good. Okay. Okay. Deepra, sir.
Okay. So I am.
Yes, sir.
Where you belong? Means so your native place.
So I belong to Ajmer, Rajasthan.
Rajasthan.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me some beauty points about the Rajasthan?
Sir, the first beauty point about the Rajasthan is, of course, the Thar Desert. You can see various lifestyles thronging in the Thar Desert, and you also see some beautiful techniques of rainwater harvesting in the districts like Jaisalmer, Barmer, and they are a prime example of the rainwater harvesting, water conservation during the monsoon season. And another beauty coming to the places is the Pink City, Jaipur, which is, of course, happens to be the capital of the Rajasthan. In the Pink City, there's Hawa Mahal, and there's Amer Fort. And coming to my city, Ajmer, there's a world famous, the only temple of Sri Brahmaji. And also there is a Dargah of Khwaja Mohinuddin Chishti. And also the Kachoris of the Nasirabad are quite famous all over India.
Okay.
I'm asking to you that Rajasthan, what are the minerals? What are the minerals in Rajasthan we can achieve? Means what are minerals?
I'm sorry, sir. I could not hear you properly. Please.
What kind of minerals in the Rajasthan?
Sir, in Rajasthan, primarily gypsum and copper mines are there. The Khetri copper mine is famous all over India.
Okay. Any of industry which aspects minerals have you visited?
No, sir, I'm not.
There is another important mineral which is being extracted in Rajasthan. You are missing that.
Yeah, definitely you are missing a lot of minerals.
But there is very one important mineral. And there is a very famous plant for that also. I don't know exactly the location. Maybe that is in Udaipur.
Sorry.
Have you ever not heard of HZL, Hindustan Zinc Limited?
Yes, sir.
That is situated in Rajasthan, right?
Okay. Yeah. I'm sorry to record at the moment. I'm sorry.
Okay, okay. It's not an issue. Okay, so Ayan, let us ask some in general question. As you told me that you are from Rajasthan and you love Thar Desert, okay, and there is very diversity in the culture, diversity in the music, diversity in the lifestyle, and various things you have told us. Okay, so as belonging from such kind of background, okay, you may have heard about the various things, the local folks, the local music, Indian music, Indian classical music, and you told me that you have interest in playing guitar, piano, you listen to the Western music. Okay, so it is, I can see that you are interested, more interested in Western music. So you are belonging from a place which is full of Indian culture, full of Indian music, yet you have interest in Western music. How it comes to your life?
Sir, actually I am I was raised in Ajmer city and I had not that much exposure to the village side or to the cultural side because I was
okay.
in the city side and I did not get to travel that much to the Jaisalmer side exactly. The farthest that I've traveled from a city in Rajasthan is the Jodhpur. I have not gone beyond Jodhpur. So in Jodhpur, I got the taste of the cultural and folk music. That is, I got to know about the instrument that is known as Ravanatha. Ravanatha, they played near the Mehrangarh Fort. So that is why I believe that my taste in the cultural music or folk music, particularly belonging to Rajasthan, is not that much great as compared to the Western music. Western music is all over, you know, urban areas. It's all Western music only. I get to hear the Rajasthan music, Rajasthan native music, folklore in mostly weddings or the village areas, the tribal areas that are, you know, somewhat slum areas that are located near our house or near our locality. That is why I believe.
Okay. Have you ever heard, if I ask you something from music theory, okay, will you be able to answer or you will try?
I'll try.
Okay. Do you know what is C natural scale? C major natural scale.
Yes, sir. C major natural.
What are the notes?
Sir, C, D, E, F, G, A, and B. Then again.
So, why we call it a natural scale, actually?
Sir, I'm not fully aware of that, but I believe that it's located in the middle of the piano, the C.
Yeah.
The piano, that's
fine. I'm sorry. Oh, that is not the actual reason. The reason is there is no sharps or flats in this scale. You will see there is only C, D, E, F, like this only. There is no sharps or flats. That's why we call it a natural scale. Okay. And obviously, the white keys represent the natural notes, okay, the root notes, and the sharps and flats are the black notes, black keys. Okay. Then let us get to the point. If you have been placed in a situation, okay, where you have to deal with persons like you know, the staff you have in your power plant or in your manufacturing unit, okay, what will be your approach as a team leader or the site engineer? Okay, what will be your priorities in that situation?
So firstly, my priority will be try to blend with the staff, the my colleagues, as you said, to know about how they work, in what conditions can they work with maximum efficiency, and what type of motivation they need to be given. Like, some people need negative motivation, some people need positive motivation, some feel much emotional. I would like to know more about the emotional sides, like how can their emotions be triggered and how can their emotions be kept at a stable level so that does not interfere with the work. And then if a task has been assigned to my team, then of course I'll be trying to motivate my leaders that let us finish this task as soon as possible, then let's get free and do whatever we want. Like, we can go and enjoy outside and get
okay. But if you are placed in South India, as you're from Rajasthan, it is North India. We generally speak Hindi, or if there is a certain circle, then we will prefer to speak in English. Okay, but you are placed in Rajasthan, so out of Rajasthan. Okay, let us say in Kerala or Tamil Nadu, such kind of place. And over there, if there is some laborers, and you will not find that they will not be aware of English language. Okay, they may not have command over English, and they will not be able to understand the Hindi as well. So you don't know Tamil. Okay, so if such kind of situations comes, like you are being placed in such locations, then how will you handle this problem? Because language is a very big barrier. You will not be able to communicate your ideas. Okay. So you will not be able to deal with such people.
Yes, sir. Sir, at the immediate solution, if I talk about the immediate solution, then I'll be looking for someone who can speak English and Tamil as well, so that I can sort of hire him or sort of let him work with me so that he can translate my statements or my sentences to my workers. And if that is not also possible, then I'll be trying to download any mobile app or something, some software like that, so that it can translate for me. In the long run, I will try to learn some basic statements and basic words in the Tamil, and also inspire them to learn somewhat English, because English is very common across India. If you have any language barrier, I believe that English can help you cross that barrier. So I'll be motivating them to learn some simple few statements, a few phrases in the English, and I'll be also learning Tamil because that will help me, you know, my overall development as well. That is how I will approach this problem, sir.
Okay. Deepra, sir.
You have mentioned a lot of times in your resume that Arduino. Arduino. Yes. Can you tell me something about this?
Sir, Arduino is a small CPU. It is a microcontroller. You program it, you feed program into it, and it will work according to your program. So it has 13 pins in which you can attach your wires and you can attach your sensors or LEDs or any actuators or motors, etc. So Arduino, if you use, then you can program it in making very different projects or many different things. First of all, you have to make a sketch. That sketch is nothing but a program that you type. It is more like a C language. It's a simple program. Then you feed it into the Arduino using laptop or mobile, of course, mobile, and then you power the Arduino using AC supply or DC supply, anything that you want, and then it will perform the your intended program. It will run the intended program, and you will see your sketch in action.
Okay. It has I can understand. I know something about the Arduino. Can you tell me at this current situation, as we know, COVID spread all over the world. So at this situation, can we use this particular technology for something good for our society to fight from the COVID? Can you tell me how we are going to use this?
Sir, this was the main purpose that I learned this Arduino thing, actually. I believe that the world is no more mechanical. And besides, in this COVID situation, everything needs to be at least contactless or at least with minimal contact. So that can be achieved with the help of automation or some sensor things. So as I mentioned in my resume, I made an automatic hand sanitizer for my home use. I believe it's a small contribution from my side to the society. I made it for my use. It was like, there is an ultrasonic sensor, you place your hand, the ultrasonic sensor senses that there is your hand and it will drip out the sanitizer on your hand. As soon as you pull out your hand, then the sanitizer will not drip out. And also, I mentioned that I had made a contactless door locking system. So that was like you enter a passcode using a mobile and the door will open on itself if the passcode is correct. That used the servo motors, that used the infrared sensors. And also, I'm now thinking of working on something like, I also mentioned in my resume that complete room automation. That was using also that you press the button on mobile and then the corresponding tube light or fan will turn on or turn off. So now I am thinking of currently that you don't use mobile, you don't use any contact, you just show some gesture to it. Like if you show this hand to the switchboard, then the tube light will be on. And if you show this, then it will be off. Something like that. That is how I explore the Arduino. And that is how I try and make new things that can help in the society in the long run. And also some of my relatives had asked me to implement this automation system in their home, actually. So I believe I'm on the right path.
Okay. Very good. I'm going to ask some technical questions. As you mentioned, you are interested subject in theory of machine. So I'm going to ask some technical questions. Do you know gear? What is gear? Can you define it?
So gears can be defined as toothed wheels, which have teeth on its periphery. And this gear meshes with another gear to transfer the power and torque from one shaft to another. There can be two gears. There can be more than two gears comprising a single gear train. That depends on the distance between the shafts and the amount of and the rotation of the shaft that you desire. So, and gear is a positive drive. That means there will be no slippage in the gear meshing. And, unlike the belted drive or the friction disc, there will be no slippage in gear train. And the gears found a very well wide range of applications like in the IC engines, in any machine we see that requires the power transmission or the speed reduction, like in lathe machines, we find gears, and also now automobiles also in gearbox and all.
Okay. So is there any special profile required for the manufacturing of the teeth, or what kind of special profile required there?
Sorry, sir, can you please repeat?
What kind of special profile required for the gear teeth?
Sir, for manufacturing the gear teeth, the machine is used, the machine which is used is milling machine, and there is a special attachment for that. And the profile generally used in gears is an involute profile in manufacturing.
Okay. Let me ask you, if I'm going to a random profile in a teeth, okay, I have one gear and I'm using a random profile, and I wanted to other profile be same ho jaye. Are you getting my point?
गियर
एंड कैसे होगा? गियर का लाइट डेप्रिसिएशन कैसे होगा? हाउ लाइट डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ गियर?
सर, गियर कैन बी डैमेज्ड इन सेवरल वेज, वन ऑफ देम बीइंग द वियर फेलियर, दैट द सरफेस ऑफ द गियर टूथ विल बी damaged by fitting or by small craters during the meshing, and also in a spiral gear, in the spur gears, the contact is all of a sudden, contact between teeth is sudden contact, so that will be placing some stress on the junction of the gear teeth and the gear disc, so that will be, due to this stress there can be also bending failure of the gear tooth. The gear tooth will be subjected to the breaking stress at the neck, at the portion of the junction.
That is base part.
As you mentioned, there are involute profile. Apart from the involute profile, any or do you know any other profile of teeth?
Sir, cycloidal profile also.
Okay. Why we are going to use this profile, like involute profile or cycloidal profile? Why?
Sir, can you repeat, please? You're not clearly audible.
Why we are stick to involute or cycloidal? Why I cannot use any other profile?
Sir, I don't have any exact idea, but I believe that the reason being that involute profile is the easiest to manufacture, and cycloidal being somewhat difficult to manufacture, and other profiles I believe that will be resulting more wear, or maybe they are more difficult to manufacture. That is, I guess, the right answer.
Okay. Involute profile, there is a particular profile. If I'm going to generate a flat surface compared to the generation of flat surface, to generate the involute profile, it will take more time, it will take more skill, it will take more difficulty to generate a involute profile compared to a flat surface. But I'm not going to use a flat surface, I'm going to use what? Involute profile. Why?
Sir, if the size of the pinion, the gear teeth is very small, then involute and flat surface are almost same. You can use a flat surface, flat profile as well for small teeth. And the precise reason for using the involute teeth is that the contact is not that much sudden as in case of flat profile, and also there the chances of slipping will be very much reduced, I believe.
Actually, can we say that flat profile is not able to follow log gearing? Involute profile follows log gearing. Involute profile follows log gears, but flat profiles not.
Yes, sir.
That's why we are using what involute profile. Okay, as you mentioned, two kind of profile are there. One is involute, another one is conjugate. Another one is your cycloidal profile. Both are actually conjugate profile. As I mentioned, the word conjugate. Do you know what is the meaning of conjugate here?
Sir, you are not clearly audible. I think network is fluctuating, sir. I'm sorry.
Hello. यार मेरी आवाज आ रही है प्रॉपरली?
अब आई सर, अब आई।
हाँ, मैं कह रहा हूँ कि आपका, हाँ, आपका जो इन्वॉल्यूट प्रोफाइल है और जो साइक्लॉइडल प्रोफाइल है, इसको कॉन्जुगेट प्रोफाइल कहा जाता है। कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस कॉन्जुगेट वर्ड? इस वर्ड का मीनिंग क्या है? कैन यू टेल मी
सर? कॉन्जुगेट वर्ड यू आर आस्किंग?
Yes.
So, conjugate word, I think stands for those two objects which complete each other, which complement each other. So, if you make an involute profile, then other involute profile will be complementing each other in terms of shape and in terms of meshing. So, that is, I think, the key for calling them conjugate profiles.
One most important term is that both log bearing at each and every point. Remember this one. Okay. Okay, let me ask, do you know interference?
Sorry, sir?
Interference of gears.
Sir, I'm a little foggy on it, like I can't properly define interference, but it is something like the addendum circle of one gear goes beyond the base circle periphery, extends into the base circle of the second gear. So that will result in improper meshing and wear and tear in the gear.
Okay. So to avoid the interference, can you tell me methods? How many methods do you know to avoid the interference?
So one of the methods is undercutting, that at the base of the gear tooth, you remove some portion of the metal so that the addendum, the gear tooth of the another gear does not collide with the base part of the second gear tooth. So that is why I provide some undercutting. But that will reduce the beam strength of the gear. The gear will be weaker at that section. And the second method is that you use involute profile. Involute profile allows some degree of interference without affecting the operation that much, but the undercutting is, I think, options.
Okay. अगर मैं कहूँ कि आपको क्या ये interference सिर्फ और सिर्फ involute profile पे मिलता है या और दूसरे जैसे आपने बोला cycloidal profile उससे भी interference होता है, मतलब कोई किसी भी gear में interference होता है?
सर साइक्लॉइडल में नहीं होता सर.
आर यू श्योर?
यस सर.
ओके वेनु सर.
ओके सो आयन, इन योर प्रोजेक्ट्स यू हैव डन अ प्रोजेक्ट, आई एम कॉलिंग इट इट्स नेम, अ सप्लायर सिलेक्शन एंड ऑर्डर एलोकेशन मॉडल विथ मल्टीपल ट्रांसपोर्टेशन अल्टरनेटिव. ओके सो फर्स्ट टेल मी, यू नो, व्हाट इज द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ दिस प्रोजेक्ट, फ्रॉम व्हिच बैकग्राउंड इट कम्स?
So it is a project related to the operation research side. It is my PhD project actually.
Okay. Is it dealing with the supply chain management or something like that?
So not exactly supply chain management, but it is more of like a transportation problem. You have M suppliers and N transportation alternatives. Then you assign each supplier to each transportation alternative with taking into account various factors like inputs, inputs like the cost, the ordering cost, the transportation cost, the quality score that has been assigned to the suppliers, and the lead time. Actually, one upon lead time has been taken as the output, and also the one upon lead reciprocal of lead time variance. So it is more like a assignment problem.
Okay. So to find out the transportation alternatives, that means there will be number of vendors which are going to give you some logistic or you can say transportation solution, and you will be selecting a certain number of person for allocating certain tasks, right? Is it like that? Okay, so you will be going to use some assignment models. Let me ask you, during your GATE preparation, you have been going through the syllabus, right, of operation and research. Have you ever, completed the syllabi of assignment models?
Yes, I did.
Okay, so do you know what are the various methods for solving any kind of assignment problem? What are their names, if you know any of those?
Sir, first method I remember is the Northwest Corner Rule. The second method is Hungarian method.
Okay. Tell me about the Northwest Corner Rule.
So the Northwest Corner Rule, you prepare a table on the top of which there is number of units demanded, and on the column on the left side of the table, you write down the suppliers that are going to supply those demands, and how many maximum units can each supplier supply, and on the bottom of the table you write how much maximum demand is there. Then you go to the top northwest corner, that is the top left corner, and you noting the supplier maximum limitation and noting the demand, you assign the demand such that the demand is fulfilled or the supplier is completely exhausted, whichever is possible. Then you cut out that corner. If the supplier has been exhausted, then you cut out the supplier line. If the demand has been fulfilled, you cut out the demand line. Then you
this is the proper procedure. Okay. So it is nice. Okay. So you have done a lot of projects, I can see, and which is very good. Okay, to develop your practical knowledge and technical command. Okay, so you have done a lot, related to some electronic gadgets, I will say. Okay, so there are many things in your CV, I can see. Can you tell me what is servo motor and how it is different from a regular motor we see in our schools, in some toys you will find some motor. Okay, normal DC motor will be there. So what is basic difference between a normal regular motor or geared motor or a servo motor?
Sir, let me first talk about the normal motor. The normal motor is based on the electromagnetic phenomenon. That is, you have an armature coil and then you have a shaft that is passing through the armature coil. You give the current to the armature coil, it generates a magnetic field, it generates a torque on the shaft rod and it rotates. That is the basic principle of the normal motor. For servo motor, it works on electric pulses and it has a limitation that it rotates only from 0 degree to 180 degree. It cannot make any full rotation, and that too based on the electric pulses that it receives. And that electric pulses can be programmed using the Arduino as added or any other voltage or current limitation. I'm not fully aware of that because I'm not in electronics field.
Okay,
so,
okay.
Servo motor. Yes,
okay, sir. So it is only AC operated or DC operated?
Servo motor, are you asking?
Yeah.
Sir, DC operated.
Only DC operated?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
There are AC operated servo motors also. You can, if you are interested in this field, you will find variety of AC working servo motors. Okay, so if I ask you that, is the microcontroller, okay, will be the integrated part of a servo motor, or you can use a servo motor without any microcontroller?
So I have not tested this idea yet, actually, but I believe the microcontroller should be an integrated part of the servo motor.
Yeah, this should be. Otherwise, there is no relevance of using the servo motors. Okay. Okay. So, in geared motor, I will ask. Geared motor, you have seen in normal robotics competition, okay, students are generally going to use the geared motor, okay. No. So, what is the fundamental of a geared motor? Can you tell me? What are the fundamental components of a geared motor?
Sorry, sir, I'm not able to recall it.
Okay, so there will be a gearbox and there will be a DC or AC motor, nothing else. Okay, so if you have ever used that, gear motor. You'd have, okay, okay. So there is no use of those kind of gears in your area of interest, right?
Not yet.
Okay, okay. So you have worked in as a trainee in Sri Ambika Cables Private Limited, Ajmer, from May 2019 to June 2010. This is a vocational training, I think.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what you have learned from this internship?
Sir, my primary objective was to gain the first-hand experience of an industrial environment. What happens inside a factory, what actually happens inside an industrial environment. And the first thing that I learned was how different machines are operated, how the workers behave when they're operating these machines. You know, some workers are very much experienced, so they do the task, do the machining operation without any drawing or without any complex methods. They just do the simple things. And some workers which are new there, they use a drawing, they learn from other workers about the different processes that can be used to perform that operation. And also that we read in the books about in the wages and incentive chapter that you find difficult to apply new methods of a standard procedure in the factory because you face somewhat resistance from the workers. They are not willing to change. So that okay. I experienced firsthand in that industry. That was, there was some, the coordination between the management and the workers could have been slightly better, I felt. So this was the experience I gained there.
Okay, so you generally experienced only managerial things, not all the technical part.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you don't have any idea what kind of products were there, what kind of machinery was involved. Do you have any idea about that?
Yes, sir. I have an idea about that. There were lathe machines, there were milling machines, shaper machines, planer machines, and there was other separate areas for the heat treatment of the machines that were being manufactured. Actually, this industry manufactures the machines which will be used in the making of cables. So for those okay.
There was any treatment, sir.
So there was annealing and there was quenching in that industry.
What okay. is annealing?
So in annealing, the metal piece which you are working upon is heated in the furnace above the recrystallization temperature, and then it is allowed to cool at a slow and controlled rate. More generally in the furnace itself, so that the properties are somewhat altered, like hardness and the toughness, and also the grain structure modifies itself at a controlled rate.
Okay, as you mentioned, there are quenching also there. So why quenching was required there? As you mentioned.
Sorry, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Quenching required था वहाँ पे. Quenching क्यों चाहिए था? मतलब जैसे एनिलिंग ही करना है मुझे तो क्वेंचिंग प्रोसेस जो देखिए आप है ना तो कौन कौन से क्वेंचिंग प्रोसेस देखिए ये सबसे पहले मुझे बता दीजिए
सर क्वेंचिंग ऑफ स्टील आई हैव सीन सर क्वेंचिंग ऑफ यू हैव स्टील देन
इससे किससे क्वेंचिंग कर रहे थे बाय एयर बाय वाटर और बाय ऑयल
सर बाय वाटर बाय वाटर देयर वाज अ वाटर जेट एक्चुअली
ओके
तो ये पंचिंग कर रहे थे ये जो वाटर पंचिंग है इसमें किस टाइप के स्ट्रक्चर्स बनते हैं कोई आइडिया
सर आई थिंक स्टील स्ट्रक्चर्स आर मेनली यूज्ड इन पंचिंग स्टील प्रोडक्ट्स आर यूज्ड
मार्टिन साइड
यस सर मार्टिन साइड स्ट्रक्चर्स
मार्टिन साइड स्ट्रक्चर सुने है ना क्या होता है मार्टिन साइड स्ट्रक्चर
सो मार्टिन साइड आई एम सॉरी सर आई एम नॉट एबल टू रिकॉल
ओके ठीक है वेलकम सर What
yes. So, there was a setup like this, you have told me. Okay. So, it is basically a cable manufacturing company. So, can you please tell me what is the fundamental process, okay, involved in manufacturing of a cable and what was the, what was the raw material, okay, being what the, what was the material of the wires? Then aluminum wires were there. Copper wires were there or steel wires were there. What kind of wires were being manufactured in that plant?
So actually, not the cable manufacturing factory. It was the manufacturing of machines which will be used after in the future for manufacturing cables. But yeah, I know the process of manufacturing cables. There are, firstly, there is metal ingots which are extracted from the metal ores. The generally used metal ores are copper and aluminium. And then the ingots are melted and then they are hot rolled into the rods, the cylindrical rods. And then these rods are gradually reduced in cross-section area by rolling operation, sequential reduction. And then the cables are wound in a coil. Then these wires are then twisted, two or three or six wires maybe, that depends upon the requirement. They are twisted together to form a cable. And then insulation is done. After that insulation, if required, then more wires can be twisted. Like we can see in the three and a half phase wires. We have three cables in that. So more cables can be twisted on that and more insulation. And then finally, after that, if the cable is subjected to some physical fatigue, physical damage, if it is supposed to withstand some physical damage like underground cables or the high tension cables, then armoring is also done for that cables and final insulation is done. Then we have the ready cables.
Okay, so coming to the insulation part, why we use insulation actually in cables?
So insulation is used to minimize the heat loss from the cables so as to minimize the energy loss and improve the power transmission.
Okay. Is there any other aspect of using insulation?
I don't know, sir.
Basically, it is very basic. It is human safety. Okay, deep breath, sir.
आपने बोला कि minimize the heat loss, है ना? Insulation जो use करते हैं, minimize the heat loss. अगर मैं heat loss को वहाँ पे minimize करूँगा, है ना? तो मतलब मेरा वहाँ पे जो heat generation हो रहा है, वो किस वजह से हो रहा है? Because of the flow of
electrons.
Flow of current. उसकी वजह से हीट जनरेशन हो रहा है. तो उसे हीट जनरेशन को मिनिमाइज करने की जरूरत है या मैक्सिमाइज, सॉरी, जो हीट रिमूवल है उसको मिनिमाइज करने की जरूरत है कि मैक्सिमाइज करने की जरूरत है? जो हीट रिमूव होगा, मतलब एक जो वायर है उस पर हीट जनरेशन होगा बिकॉज ऑफ द करंट सप्लाई. अब हीट जनरेशन हो रहा है तो इसको मुझे क्या करना पड़ेगा? एटमोसफियर में ट्रांसफर करना पड़ेगा. तो जो हीट ट्रांसफर है उसको मिनिमाइज करने की जरूरत है कि मैक्सिमाइज करने की जरूरत है?
जब
हम इंसुलेशन करेंगे तो जो आउटर सरफेस एरिया है वायर का या केबल का, आउटर सरफेस एरिया वो बढ़ेगा. तो उसके बढ़ने से सर जो कन्वेक्शन अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ कूलिंग, जिसमें एरिया अगर ज्यादा होगा तो उससे हीट ट्रांसफर रेट भी ज्यादा मिलेगी. इसलिए सर हमारा हीट ट्रांसफर मैक्सिमाइज होगा, इंक्रीज होगा.
तो मैं अगर कंटिन्यूअसली उसको बढ़ाते रहूंगा वो सरफेस को, है ना, कंटिन्यूअसली अगर मैं उसके इंसुलेशन डालते जा रहा हूँ तो वो इंक्रीज होगा. मेरे हिसाब से तो इंसुलेशन का कंडक्टिविटी कम होता है, वहां से तो डिक्रीज होना चाहिए हीट ट्रांसफर.
सर एक्चुअली एक लिमिट तक इंक्रीज होगा, उसके बाद डिक्रीज होना शुरू हो जाएगा. क्योंकि सर उसके बाद जो इंसुलेटिंग मटेरियल है उसकी भी थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी की वजह से जो रेजिस्टेंस होगा वो भी सर रोल प्ले करेगा अपना. तो
वो लिमिट जहां पे मैक्सिमम हीट ट्रांसफर मिलता है उसको क्या कहा जाता है?
सो क्रिटिकल रेडियस ऑफ इंसुलेशन.
वेरी वेरी गुड.
आपने सारी बातें बताई ना, कुछ इस पॉइंट पर स्टार्ट किया. आपने बोला कि केबल बनाने के लिए सर हम इंगोट लाते हैं, है ना? अब मैं कह रहा हूँ कि यार मेरे पास ना एल्युमिनियम का एक ऐसा प्लांट है जहां से मैं लिक्विड एल्युमिनियम जनरेट कर सकता हूँ. मतलब एल्युमिनियम का जो ओर है वहां से एक्सट्रैक्ट किया और एल्युमिनियम का लिक्विड फॉर्म में मैं ले आया. मुझे कास्टिंग करना है. अल्टीमेटली क्या करूंगा मैं? कास्टिंग करके तो इंगोट बनाने वाला हूँ. तो मैं चाहता हूँ कि जो लिक्विड एल्युमिनियम है वहीं से क्या मैं डायरेक्ट वायर जनरेट कर सकता हूँ? जो केबल है आप, इज देयर एनी प्रोसेस बाय विच यू कैन जनरेट डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द लिक्विड मेटल टू द वायर? कैन यू जनरेट?
Sir, I have no idea, sir. I have no idea of such process, sir. I'm sorry.
Okay. There is process that is known as continuous property process. Continuous property. That is also continuous, continuous casting here. And all over world, more than 80 to 90% जो वायर है मैन्युफैक्चर होता है वो इसी प्रोसेस में होता है. ओके, साथ के साथ इंडिया में हम लोग हालांकि बहुत कम जगह यूज करते हैं, लेकिन डू यू नो बाल्को, बाल्को वेदांता, तो ये ग्रुप्स हैं जो यूज करते हैं ये पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस. ठीक है. ओके वेणु सर.
जी सर. So, how are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling very much like I'm talking to my seniors. Actually, I'm getting very much knowledge from you to teachers and to faculties. So, I'm very much feeling like a nursery or LKG student that is getting knowledge.
Okay, so you are enjoying the session actually. So you have mentioned your area of interest in your CV. First is strength of material, second heat transfer, third is fluid mechanics, then your robotics part. So I'm going to ask you a question from fluid mechanics. Okay, so if you just define a fluid, just define fluid.
Sir, fluid is that state of matter in which if apply any shear force, any shear deformation to it, then it will not resist the deformation. It will keep on deforming itself, and it will offer least or minimal resistance to the deformation. That is fluid.
Okay. Don't you think that this definition of fluid, okay, has certain boundaries, like it is bounded to the subject fluid mechanics only? I'm just going to ask you that what is fluid? If you go into the dictionary and you will search for what is fluid, is it going to give you the same statement which you have made right now? Yes, I'm just saying that if there is a person who don't know what is shear stress, but whatever such kind of the continuous deformation kind of things, this technical word is not aware of it. And if you're tossing this kind of a statement, then he's not going to understand, right? So just simply, in the simplest form, define fluid.
So in simplest form, I would say that anything that flows is a fluid.
Yeah, this is the fundamental definition of fluid actually. So in fluid mechanics, you will be defining the fluid in the basis of forces or, you know, and in the motion and the deformation kind of thing. Okay. So what is Newtonian fluid?
So Newtonian fluid is that fluid which obeys the Newton's law of viscosity.
Any examples?
So water can be treated as a Newtonian fluid.
Okay. So water. In water, you will see that there are a lot of properties, and it is very useful for us. You know, we drink water, we use water for power production. Okay. So if there is a plant, hydraulic power plant. Okay. What will be the fundamental elements, fundamental components of a hydraulic power plant?
So, firstly, there should be a reservoir of water. Like if the dam is the plant or the dam is being built on river, the river will be acting as a reservoir. Then there shall be some provision that the water from the reservoir should fall through some height, so that we can utilize that potential energy of the water to generate our power. Then there should be some power generating device like turbine on which the water will fall and they will rotate the turbine. Then the turbine will be rotating the shaft of the generator, and the generator will be generating electricity.
Okay, so what are the fundamental classifications of turbines, hydraulic turbines?
Sir, fundamental classification turbines are impulse turbine and reaction turbine.
Okay, what is basic difference between these two?
So an impulse turbine, all the pressure energy of the water is converted into the kinetic energy before hitting the blades of the turbine. While in reaction turbine, the pressure energy is not converted completely to kinetic energy. The pressure energy as well as the kinetic energy are going to hit the blades of the turbine.
Okay, so do you know anything about the degree of reaction or something?
Not, I don't remember, sir.
Okay, you don't remember. Okay, so in this kind of turbines. Okay, have you ever heard of Pelton wheel?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so just tell me the very fundamental working principle of the Pelton wheel.
So in Pelton wheel, there is a wheel attached to a shaft, and on that wheel there are buckets attached on the periphery of the wheel, and then water flows through a jet on the tangentially to the Pelton wheel, such that it strikes the buckets tangentially.
Okay.
And jet flow rate is controlled by a spindle, by spearhead, and that force of the jet makes the turbine wheel rotate as it impinges on the bucket, and then turbine wheel rotates and then it generates power.
Okay, so if I ask you that, let me tell you the velocity of the jet coming out of the nozzle. Let us say it is capital V, okay, and the bucket is moving with a peripheral velocity of small u. Okay, then what will be the velocity of the jet entering or hitting the buckets?
So the velocity of the jet will be V minus u.
Okay, so we will be going to take the relative velocity. Okay, so you will see that there is a spear in the nozzle part. Okay, in order to control the outlet of the nozzle. Okay, so what is the machine? Okay, what is the device which operates this spear? Do you know the name of that device?
Sir, I think it's governor.
Okay, so can you tell me a fundamental working of governing of a turbine?
Sir, I don't remember, sir.
It is very important, governing of engines, governing of turbines. These are very important aspects, and as an engineer, okay, you must be aware of these facts. Okay, so it will be very useful for your future work. Okay, whenever you will be placed in a power plant, it may be like coal fired or it may be a hydraulic power plant, you must be aware of governing of the turbine. Okay, so are you interested in power plant or such type of arrangements, such type of machinery, steam turbines, boilers, etc.?
Not that interesting, sir.
Okay, so you okay. Deep process.
Okay, I'm going to ask you last few questions. आप आज से 5 साल बाद अपने आप को कहाँ देखते हैं?
सर, सबसे पहले तो मैं एक बेहतर इंसान बनूंगा जैसा मैं अभी हूँ. उससे मैं अपनी कुछ टेस्ट पे काम करूंगा ताकि मैं लोगों के सामने और अच्छा एग्जांपल दे सकूं. एंड प्रोफेशनली मैं अपने आप को देखता हूँ कि मैं एक अच्छे कॉलेज में, मेरा एम है एक्चुअली एजुकेशनल फील्ड में जाके एजुकेशन इम्पार्ट करना दूसरों को. तो मैं एक अच्छे कॉलेज में एक डिसेंट जॉब कॉन्ट्रैक्ट के साथ में मैं टीचिंग कर रहा हूँ सर, एज अ जूनियर प्रोफेसर.
ओके, सो इफ यू इफ देयर इज अ सिचुएशन लाइक यू आर बीइंग सिलेक्टेड इन एनटीपीसी, okay, or IOCL, it is going to offer you like about 15 lakhs. If IOCL I talk about, if in ICL you are, IOCL you are being offered 14 lakh or 15 lakh, something around that. Okay, and you are going to be a professor somewhere, and there will be a package of, let us say, 7 lakhs or 8 lakhs per annum. Okay, in any college, let us say 7 lakh or 8 package was will be there. So you can see there is a huge difference in the salary you are going to have. So what will be your decision at that time? There is a teaching job which is going to offer you 7 to 8 lakhs. There is a technical job in very awesome, you know, very prestigious institute, IOCL, a prestigious plant of India. So a big profile is there. You know, you are an engineer in IOCL who is earning 14 to 15 lakhs per annum, and you are a teacher in some college. It may be a private college, it may be a government college, and you are earning 8 lakhs. What will be your preference and what is the reason?
Sir, I'll be choosing the teaching line because what I believe is that I have a little less interest in the IOCL or the technical side. So if I ever happen to join that organization, then I'll be doing my job or my task with little interest. So that way I'll be harming myself also, and that way I'll be harming, doing some damage to the organizational goals also. And I don't want any of the organization to get any damage because of my loss of interest. And as a teaching line, yes, I agree that there is some less salary, but actually I will be satisfied and I'll be somewhat more relaxed. I will be getting more time to spend with the family. Actually, my father is also a teacher. So I see the engineers who are employed in these organizations, and I see my father. I feel like my father is more privileged to have a job in this teaching line. And I believe that you earn the students of respect, and you earn the respect of the students, and nothing is more beautiful than that. No more beautiful feeling, I believe.
Okay, so if there is another condition, let us say, okay, there is a job offer from a very prestigious coaching institute. It may be of technical background, like it is going to offer you a teaching profile for GATE preparations or ESE preparations. Okay, there is another coaching institute, okay, which is going to give you a good and a handsome salary, but it is going to ask you to teach physics or, you know, school level or IIT, JEE, NEET, such kind of content. So there are, you know, coaching institutes. They are going to offer you 70 to 80 lakhs per annum. 70 to 80 lakhs per annum. There is another job profile. It may be, you know, just assume that you have completed your PhD, postdoc, etc. And there is a job offer from IIT or IISc you are going to teach. So there will not be that much money involved in that condition, right? You will not be going to earn that money as the money you can earn from coaching institutes. So in that situation, money will be a big difference. You may be earning only 12 to 13 lakhs being a professor or assistant professor in IIT or IISc. Okay. And you are going to earn 70 to 80 lakhs or maybe 1 crore per annum by teaching in a coaching institute. So what will be your preference? Both are teaching profiles. What will be your decision in that condition?
So then my decision will be, let me be very practical. My decision will be the coaching institutes, because I feel that the students connect more with the coaching institutes than the colleges. And I mean, it is maybe it is morally wrong, but it is practical. And in that case, I will be doing teaching, but secondarily, I'll be looking for monetary purposes also, because I have to earn my living also.
Deepra, sir.
Paisa bhi zaruri hai, keh raha hai. So I think बस है ना यहाँ पे end करते हैं आपका interview. सर आपको और कोई question पूछना है इसके अलावा?
नहीं सर, I'm totally satisfied. बाकी तो फिर आप करेंगे ही बात अभी आया उनसे.
ठीक है फिर interview यहाँ interview end करते हैं. अब बात करेंगे हम आपका जो भी feedback होगा उसके बारे में. ठीक है, इंटरव्यू एंड हुआ है, अब फीडबैक के बारे में बात करते हैं.
थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू वेरी मच
सर.
मैं आपको अगर मैं बोलना चाहूँ तो ओवरऑल इंटरव्यू आपको कैसा लगा कि कैसा गया?
सर नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम आई सर, आप क्लियर नहीं आ रही है.
आपका इंटरव्यू कैसे गया आपके हिसाब
से? सर मैं अपने आप को 10 में से 8 रेट करूंगा सर, मुझे ऐसा लगता है. टेक्निकल में मैं थोड़ा इम्प्रूव कर सकता हूं, पर अच्छा मुझे लगता है कि मैं एकदम ऑनेस्ट हूं. मैं बिल्कुल ऑनेस्टी के साथ बोला सर.
ओके,
लेकिन अगर मैं मान लीजिए सर अगर सेलेक्ट होता हूँ तो बहुत ही अच्छी बात है, सेलेक्ट नहीं होता हूँ तो थोड़ा डिसअपॉइंटमेंट तो होगा, लेकिन मुझे कुछ नया ही सीखने को मिलेगा सर. मैं उसको ग्रेसफुली एक्सेप्ट करूंगा.
वेरी गुड. ओवरऑल अगर मैं बोलूँ तो मुझे एचआर वाला जो साइड है मुझे यस अच्छा लगा ओवरऑल मेरा अनुभव जिस हिसाब से है ना. बाकी तो वेनु सर को, क्योंकि हर जगह ना थोड़ी सी चीजें जो होती है वो अलग होती है, अब वेनु सर वो फीडबैक देंगे तो वो बताएंगे क्या होगा. लेकिन मुझे यस अच्छा लगा. टेक्निकल में मुझे लगा कि यस इम्प्रूवमेंट की नीड है. तो मुझे जो लगे कि आप जो पेन पेपर यूज कर रहे थे, यू आर टेकिंग लॉट ऑफ टाइम है ना, और मुझे नहीं लगता कि सारे इंटरव्यू में इस तरीके से चीजों को अलाउ किया जाएगा. कई बार ये ऐसा भी होता है कि आपके ऊपर ना क्वेश्चन से क्वेश्चन लगातार आते जाएंगे, वो 10 सेकेंड तक वेट नहीं करेंगे कि इतना आप वहां पे कर रहे हो. ठीक है ना. और कुछ ऐसे इंटरव्यू जैसे कि अगर मैं बोलूँ अ काइंड ऑफ जैसे रिसर्च ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, आपका आपका इंटरेस्ट है टीचिंग में, तो आपको रिसर्च ऑर्गेनाइजेशन भी पसंद आए, ठीक, लाइक बार्क, डीआरडीओ, इसरो, इस तरीके के जो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है जिनको एक टीचर बनने की चाहत है, उनको इस तरीके का ऑर्गेनाइजेशन भी बहुत पसंद आता है, ठीक है। तो अगर ऐसे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के लिए अगर आप इंटरव्यू जाते हो, है ना, मुझे लगता है कि आपने प्लान किया होगा, है ना, तो अगर आप इंटरव्यू ऐसा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के लिए जाते हो तो वहां पे आपको शॉर्ट ऑफ ऐसा देखा जाएगा, टेक्निकल इंटरव्यू, मेनली टेक्निकल इंटरव्यू होगा वहां पे, और टेक्निकल इंटरव्यू में आपको ना खींचते चले जाएंगे, एक क्वेश्चन को ही खींचते चले जाएंगे वहां पे। ऑब्वियसली हमारा जो थॉट प्रोसेस है, हम चीजों को सोच के आंसर करते हुए चलेंगे, प्रॉपरली सोच के आंसर करते हुए चलेंगे, लेकिन उनका ज्यादा इंटरेस्ट ये रहता है कि आपका अप्रोच क्या है, आप क्या उस डिस्कशन में पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हो प्रॉपरली, या सिर्फ आप जॉब लेने बैठे हो, है ना। जॉब लेने अगर बैठे हैं तो वो थोड़ा सा परेशान हो जाएगा, जब डेढ़ घंटे तक एक ही क्वेश्चन में लगातार कुछ ना कुछ आ रहा है तो परेशान हो जाएगा, वो डिस्कशन नहीं करेगा। बट द पर्सन हु आर इंटरेस्टेड फॉर द रिसर्च, है ना, जो रिसर्च में इंटरेस्टेड है वो डिस्कशन में मजा लेगा, डेढ़ घंटा का दो घंटा और बैठा हुआ है ना। तो वो एक मुझे लगता है एक पॉइंट है कि ये ध्यान रखना है, अगर हम जा रहे हैं तो प्रॉपरली पार्टिसिपेट करें। और अभी तो डिस्कशन में ठीक अच्छी थी आपकी, है ना, ओवरऑल मुझे लगता है कि यस टेक्निकली थोड़ा सा स्ट्रॉन्ग होने की जरूरत है, कुछ कुछ पॉइंट में जैसे हम बात करते हैं, ओवरऑल ठीक है मेरे, ठीक है वेनु सर।
हाँ हम आते हैं आपके सीवी पे, सीवी को थोड़ा सा ना थोड़ा सा और अट्रैक्टिव बना सकते हो आप, है ना, थोड़ा सा इसमें कुछ कुछ चीजों पे वर्क कर सकते हो। और जैसे आपने लास्ट में जो अपने बारे में जैसे लिखा है, ये हॉबीज वगैरह लिखा है आपने, स्ट्रेंथ्स लिखा हुआ है आपने, ठीक है, तो हाँ, तो इसमें जैसे कि आपसे पूछ दिया कि आपकी वीकनेसेस क्या है, है ना, तो ये स्ट्रेंथ वाला पार्ट, मतलब इसको इसको थोड़ा सा, ये जो आपने साइड हेडिंग डाली है स्ट्रेंथ करके, उसमें पॉइंट्स जो लिखे हैं उसको थोड़ा अच्छे से इम्प्रूव कीजिएगा, मतलब उसकी हेडिंग कुछ चेंज करके आप उसमें सर्च कर सकते हैं, यानी कि सम पर्सनल डिटेल्स, या यू नो एक जो जनरल बायो जैसे हम लोग सोशल साइट्स पे लिखते हैं, तो एक उस तरीके का आप लिख सकते हो। आपने यहाँ पर्सनल डिटेल्स जैसे डाली है, ठीक है, उसमें डेट ऑफ बर्थ आपने मेंशन किया है, फादर ने मेंशन किया, बेटा मदर ने मेंशन नहीं किया है, जो कि एक वीक पॉइंट है, ठीक है। और आपने नंबर जो आपके फैमिली मेंबर्स हैं, जैसे कि आप उसके बारे में आप इंफॉर्मेशन दे सकते हो, ठीक है, ओके, ये सब। और पर्सनल डिटेल में कुछ देना चाहो लाइक, तो और भी आप उसमें इंक्लूड कर सकते हो, बट मदर नेम इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ठीक है, ये आप बिल्कुल इसको कीजिएगा। और अगर आप चाहें तो फादर का प्रोफेशन, मदर का प्रोफेशन वगैरह, ये सब भी एक्स्ट्रा है, ये अगर आप चाहें तो, एक मतलब इट इज नॉट अ मस्ट, ये होना चाहिए। और जैसे कि अभी ये हमारे पास डिजिटली आया है लाइक, है ना, ये हमारे पास सीवी डिजिटली आया है, तो ये तो जैसे आईआईटीज वगैरह तो प्रॉपर एक फॉर्म फिल कराया जाएगा, है ना, मैक्सिमम जगह प्रॉपर एक फॉर्म होता है, तो उसमें ये सीवी वाली डिटेल्स ही जाती हैं। और आप जैसे अपनी फाइल रखते हो, तो फाइल के जो आपकी फाइल होगी जिसमें आपकी पूरी डिग्रीज और सर्टिफिकेशंस एक्सेट्रा है, उसका जो फर्स्ट स्लाइसेस जो होते हैं उसमें आप सीवी लगाते हो, तो अगर वो आपकी फाइल ओपन करते हैं, ऑब्वियस सी बात है, जो कि मैक्सिमम चांसेस में करा जाएगा, तो आपकी सीवी वो खोलेंगे। तो सीवी में कभी भी याद रखना, सीवी में ना जो डिक्लेरेशन वाला पार्ट है, डिक्लेरेशन में डेट और आपका सिग्नेचर हमेशा होना चाहिए, ठीक है। तो जैसे यहाँ पर डिजिटल था, तो डिजिटल में भी डिजिटल साइन आप रख सकते हो, यू नो एक स्कैन वाला फॉर्मेट रख सकते हो, और जो किस डेट का सीवी है, तो रिसेंटली अपडेटेड है, ये वो डेट दिखाएगा, तो डेट एक इसमें आप बिल्कुल मेंशन कीजिएगा डिक्लेरेशन वाले पार्ट में, ठीक है। ये वाला तो आपके फॉर्मेटिंग के हिसाब से हो गया। हॉबीज जैसे आप लिखे हो, तो हॉबीज में देखिए आप प्लेइंग टेबल टेनिस, क्रिकेट, चेस, अभी आप बोल सकते हैं कि हम लोगों ने उसको, हम लोग मैंने जस्ट म्यूजिक वाले पार्ट से ज्यादा क्वेश्चन किए। जैसे अभी आप टेबल टेनिस करते, अभी जितने भी इंटरव्यूज हुए सबको मैंने ये सजेशन दिया है कि जैसे आप स्पोर्ट्स डाले हैं हॉबीज में, तो हॉबीज में कोई एक स्पोर्ट्स ज्यादा डालिए, समझ रहे हो आप, जैसे कि तीन स्पोर्ट्स डालते हो, है ना, हर इंटरव्यू में अपन लोग कुछ कुछ नया पार्ट बताते हैं, तो इसमें आप जो भी सुन रहे हैं, जितने भी स्टूडेंट्स ये वीडियो को देख रहे हैं, तो कभी भी कोई एक स्पोर्ट्स डालो। और सबसे आसान जो है ना स्पोर्ट्स में, वो याद रखने के लिए जनरली क्रिकेट होता है लड़कों के लिए, बट अगर नहीं है क्रिकेट में इंटरेस्ट, जीरो इंटरेस्ट है, तो डिफरेंट बात है। तो जैसे हॉबीज में इसको आप प्लान कर सकते हो, ओनली वन डालो, सिर्फ क्रिकेट डालो, ठीक है। चेस डालोगे तो फिर आपसे नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन करेगा कि अभी वर्ल्ड चैंपियन कौन है, ग्रैंड मास्टर कौन है, ठीक है, कुछ बेसिक से एक आध मूव्स पूछ देगा आपसे, अगर सामने वाला नॉलेजेबल। जैसे मुझे म्यूजिक में इंटरेस्ट ज्यादा है, मुझे स्पोर्ट्स में, क्योंकि एक पर्सन पे डिपेंड करता है, जैसे मैं एज ए इंटरव्यूअर जब आपके साथ था, तो मुझे क्रिकेट मैच से छोटा इंटरेस्ट नहीं। हाँ मुझे चेस में बिल्कुल इंटरेस्ट है, टेबल टेनिस के बारे में मुझे लगभग जीरो आइडिया है, तो मैं उधर नहीं पूछूंगा क्वेश्चन ज्यादा। मैं चेस के बारे में पूछ सकता था आपसे, बट अगर सपोज मैं, सपोज आईआईटी का कोई आपका पैनल है उसमें मैं हूँ, मैं क्रिकेट प्लेयर रहा हूँ अपने अपने टाइम पे, नेशनल खेल चुका हूँ, तो आपसे फिर काफी कुछ मैं क्वेश्चंस पूछ सकता हूँ, जैसे कि अभी बीसीसीआई का चीफ कौन है वगैरह। ठीक है, अभी
हाँ
आपका इस तरह से आपके आपसे क्वेश्चन टॉस किए जा सकते हैं। ठीक है, अभी इंडिया ने कितने बार वर्ल्ड कप जीता है, ठीक है, लास्ट वर्ल्ड कप किसने
बहुत
जीता
बहुत
था,
बहुत
सेमी,
सारी
इस टाइप से
चीजें।
बहुत से क्रूशियल क्वेश्चंस किए जा सकते हैं। अब जैसे आपसे आपने म्यूजिक इंस्ट्रूमेंट के बारे में लिखा है गिटार, तो फिंगर स्टाइल आप प्ले करते हो है ना, तो फिंगर स्टाइल क्या होता है, फिंगर स्टाइल एक अलग से स्टाइल है, उसमें और कितने वेरिएशंस होते हैं, जैसे फ्लैमिंगो वगैरह होता है, तो कोई कोई वैसा बैठा होगा तो उसके बारे में पूछेगा, आपने कहाँ से सीखा। ठीक है, आपसे कोई म्यूजिक, जैसे मैंने आपसे क्वेश्चन कर दिया था म्यूजिक थ्योरी जिसको बोलते हैं, तो अगर आपने प्रोफेशनली सीखा है तो आपको पता होगा। आपने मेकिंग एंड एक्सप्लोरिंग, ये जो आपका सॉफ्टवेयर है आपके रोबोटिक्स रिलेटेड, उससे आपको क्वेश्चन पूछे जा सकते हैं। आपने, ये तो हो गया आपको हॉबीज वाला पार्ट, तो हॉबीज भी देखो, सीवी इज नॉट अबाउट, सीवी ऐसा नहीं है जैसे कि आप किसी एज अ पर्सन मेरे से मिलेंगे तो आप मेरे को अपने बारे में सारी चीजें सच बताएंगे, बट सीवी जो है वो डिप्लोमेटिक होता है। कभी भी सीवी एक कंट्रोल, जैसे सीवी को कैरिकुलम विटे बोलते हैं, लेकिन मैं एक उसका मैंने शॉर्ट फॉर्म बनाया है कंट्रोल्ड व्यू। आप अपने बारे में कंट्रोल्ड व्यू देते हो सामने वाले को, जिसका कंट्रोल पूरी तरह से आपके हाथ में होता है, समझ गए। तो आप इसमें जो जो पॉइंट्स लिखते हैं वहां से क्वेश्चंस उठते हैं, ठीक, तो जो भी लिखो आपको इसके बारे में पूरा आइडिया होना चाहिए। ठीक है, हॉबीज, अब ये फोकसिंग एंड डेवलपिंग न्यू स्किल एंड सेल्फ बेटरमेंट, ये जो पॉइंट है इसको आप बिल्कुल कट कीजिए यहाँ से, क्योंकि ये हॉबीज वाला पार्ट नहीं है, ये अपने पर्सनल स्किल्स या इसमें आएगा। ठीक है, जैसे अपने स्ट्रेंथ वाला जो सेगमेंट रखा है वहां डाल सकते हैं। और आपने प्रोजेक्ट्स वगैरह में बहुत सारी चीजें रखी हैं, लेकिन ये जो आपने मेरे को बताया जैसे कि समर, ये इंटर्नशिप है आपकी, समर इंटर्नशिप जो श्री अंबिका केबल्स वाला, तो ये आपका वोकेशनल ट्रेनिंग वाला पार्ट है, तो वोकेशनल ट्रेनिंग कहाँ से की गई है और उसमें आपको ग्रेडिंग क्या मिली थी, ये एक अलग सेगमेंट होना चाहिए, जबकि आपने इसको प्रोजेक्ट्स में डाल दिया है, तो प्रोजेक्ट्स वाले से इसको आप हटा सकते हैं है ना, उसको प्रॉपर एक अलग साइड हेडिंग डालिए, वोकेशनल ट्रेनिंग्स, और कहाँ कहाँ से आपने ट्रेनिंग्स ली है, उसका रिमार्क्स क्या थे उस ट्रेनिंग के, वो आप अलग से मेंशन कर सकते हैं। आपने यहाँ पर कंप्यूटर स्किल्स में सी बेसिक्स लिखा हुआ है, ऑटोकैड, सॉलिड वर्क्स, कैटिया, मैटलैब, एमएस ऑफिस, तो मैटलैब जो है बहुत ही यूजफुल एक टूल है हमारे लिए, तो मैटलैब के जो बेसिक्स हैं या अगर आपने यूज किया है तो एटलीस्ट जो जिस एस्पेक्ट में आपने यूज किया है वो आप उस पर अपना थोड़ा सा कमांड रख सकते हैं। तो ये तो रहा सीवी वाला पार्ट। अब एचआर इंटरव्यू की बात करते हैं, जैसे एचआर क्वेश्चंस जो होते हैं जनरली वो स्टार्टिंग में तो बड़े इजी होते हैं, देन वो एक हाइपोथेटिकल सिनेरियो में कन्वर्ट होता जाता है धीरे धीरे, आपको एक सिचुएशन के बारे में बताया जाएगा है ना, और वहां से आपको फिर जज किया जाएगा। तो कभी भी कोशिश करना कि आंसर जो दो थोड़ा सा आपका आंसर डिप्लोमेटिक हो, आपको एकदम ऑनेस्ट बनने की नीड नहीं है, एक लॉजिक वहां पर लॉजिकल बनने की और थोड़ा सा डिप्लोमेटिक बनने की नीड है। जैसे कि मैंने आपको एक क्वेश्चन किया कि आप कुछ इंस्टीट्यूट से पढ़ाना चाहेंगे या फिर ये, अब वहां पर क्या हो गया, देखिए आपका आपकी पर्सनालिटी को वो जज कर रहा है एचआर इंटरव्यू से, तो आपने जो स्टार्टिंग में इंटरेस्ट शो किया प्रॉपर कि मुझे सर एक्सप्लोर करना, अभी जैसे कि मैंने आपको अभी आपने सीवी में लिखा है कि आपको फोकसिंग ऑन डेवलपिंग न्यू स्किल्स एंड बेटर सेल्फ बेटरमेंट, तो सेल्फ बेटरमेंट ओके, वो तो आप कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट में भी कर सकते हो, बैट डे बाई डे एक बेटर टीचर बन सकते हो, आप सपोज सोम पढ़ा है तो सोम के एक बेटर टीचर बन सकते हो, लेकिन जब आप किसी कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट में पढ़ाते हो तो आप क्वेश्चंस और नए टाइप के क्वेश्चंस, नए टाइप के कॉन्सेप्ट्स के साथ डील करते हो जो कि ऑलरेडी डिस्कस है, वो कोई फ्यूचर का पार्ट नहीं है, वो सारी चीजें एग्जिस्टिंग है, बस आपको उस बुक में उसको एक्सप्लोर करना होगा, और अच्छे क्वेश्चंस कैसे बनेंगे, एक स्टूडेंट कैसे क्रैक कर सकता है एग्जाम, दिस विल बी योर योर एरिया ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, ये आपका जैसे हमारा है आज के डेट में, लेकिन अगर आप एक्सप्लोर करना चाहते हो फ्यूचर में नेशन बिल्डिंग में कुछ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन करना चाहते हो, सो IITs, IISc's, ये इस यानी कि प्रॉपर जो इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैं है ना, जो कॉलेजेस हैं यूनिवर्सिटीज है, वहां एक प्रोफेसर ऑप्ट करना ज्यादा बेटर होगा, तो ये दोनों दोनों में क्या है एक मतभेद है, समझ रहे हो, तो फिर आप वहां से क्या प्रोजेक्ट होता है कि आप मनी माइंडेड हो, सो इन दैट सिचुएशन सच काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशंस आपको इजिली हैंडल करनी आनी चाहिए। और टेक्निकल पार्ट में तो मैं बोलूंगा जैसे कि आपने वीटी जो डाला हुआ है, तो वीटी आपका जो प्लांट से है हीट ट्रीटमेंट वगैरह, जैसे सर पूछ रहे थे आपसे, तो हीट ट्रीटमेंट प्रोसेसेस ये सब जो है जो बेसिक्स है, गवर्निंग ऑफ टर्बाइन्स, ये जो प्रैक्टिकल वाला जो पार्ट आ जाता है ना जो डायरेक्टली अपन यूज करते हैं, उस पे आपको थोड़ा सा डिटेल, बेसिक्स तो आपका एनालिंग आपने सर को बताया, क्वेंचिंग, ये सबसे मतलब एक स्टार्टिंग सबसे एनिलिंग पढ़ते हैं, लास्ट में क्वेंचिंग पढ़ते हैं, बीच में जो नॉर्मलाइजिंग टेम्परिंग और बहुत सारा होता है, पूरा ट्रिपल टी डायग्राम जो होता है वो अच्छे से पढ़िए, ये बहुत आपके लिए हेल्पफुल रहेगा। बाकी बाकी मेरे साइड से काफी अच्छा आपने हैंडल किया अपना इंटरव्यू और काफी कॉन्फिडेंट रहे, लगभग क्वेश्चन के आप लोगों आपने आंसर अच्छे से दिए हैं। सर दीपरा सर,
बस एक ही चीज बेटा है ना कि यहाँ पे जब भी आपका इंटरव्यू होगा, अभी तो हम इंटरव्यू में जितनी भी बातें की हैं, हो सकता है उसी तरीके के क्वेश्चन है, हो सकता है इससे अलग क्वेश्चन है ना, क्योंकि इतना बड़ा एरिया है, इतना बड़ा टेक्निकल एरिया है, नॉन टेक तो फिर तो उससे भी बड़ा है ना, तो हम ये नहीं कह सकते कि किसी तरीके के क्वेश्चन पूछ, लेकिन मेरा ये मानना है कि जो कॉन्सेप्ट रहेगा ना, कॉन्सेप्ट मतलब जो चीजें आपसे एक्सपेक्ट करने का जो ट्राई करेंगे एक इंटरव्यू का, वो इसी तरीके की चीजें वो एक्सपेक्ट करने की कोशिश करेंगे। तो जो आपका एटीट्यूड है, जैसे कि एक दो जगह बस है कि आपको ना ज्यादा टाइम नहीं लेना है, वही जो मुझे लगा कि इंटरव्यू पर बहुत टाइम ले रहे हो ना, बाकी जो एटीट्यूड था टुवर्ड्स द इंटरव्यू दैट वॉज गुड है ना, सर ने कुछ इम्प्रूवमेंट बताया वो जरूर इम्प्रूव करना है ना, बाकी इसी एटीट्यूड के साथ दूसरे इंटरव्यू में आप जाना, बाकी के लिए ऑल द बेस्ट, बाकी मुझे लगता है
थैंक यू सर।